They're movie icons, living legends, larger-than-life figures who've won 3 Academy Awards between them, Robert De Niro and Al Pacino. The two rarely grant interviews, but NBC's Brian Williams was able to catch up with the dynamic duo.
They are considered 2 of the greatest actors of all time, Robert De Niro and Al Pacino. They are always compared. They are both intense Italian-Americans.
Talking to me?
They are both proud New Yorkers.
Attica! Attica!
Both are Academy Award winners.
Been a lot of bad things, Joey.
Playing some of the most memorable characters over the last 35 years.
Once you're out, there's no coming back.
Say hello to my little friend!
They have appeared in only 2 films together. In The Godfather Part 2, while they were both in the film, they were never on the screen at the same time. In the movie Heat, they finally met face to face for just 1 pivotal scene. But now, in what can only be called a momentous event, they star together in the new film, Righteous Kill.
Maybe she's a success. What, you don't believe in miracles? When you pick up a check one day, then I'll believe in miracles.
They are not the easiest men to interview, and they have never granted a side-by-side television interview until today.
How many years you know each other?
In the 60s.
When do you first remember being aware of Al?
Well, I was aware of Al. He was doing a play, Tiger Wears a Necktie. And
what was the first time you remember being aware of his name or his face?
It's interesting you would ask that, because I remember the first time I saw you, and it was on 14th Street between Avenue B and C. I was with my girlfriend at the time, who was Jill Clayburgh.
Oh, yeah.
And she said, that's really is a very good actor. Oh. He had a lot of energy. I remember that impression. He had a real energy, and kind of you could tell he had a certain fire in him.
Speaking of energy, in watching the movie, you realize that really your natural habitat is the city of New York. How much energy do you derive from that comes up through the streets of the city?
Well, New York's a great city. It always is changing into what it is at the moment, and that's as it should be.
You were both born here. You were born here, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're born in Manhattan. Everywhere you go, you can feel a different life, different, you know, it's a feast here. It's great.
And we all know what day it is. Bob, especially all you've done to help the city, how often do you get frustrated at, let's call it, the lack of progress since 9/11 downtown?
It is surprising that it's taken this long to get to a point, to get to where we are today. So I'm surprised, that's all I can say.
What does the day mean to you?
It was so unreal, and then real, that there's no describing it, explaining it.
I first thought that it was somebody was, you know, got it wrong, and then I really wanted to come back, and I couldn't get back here because there was no, because you feel the need to be here when it happened.
To reconnect. Speaking of reconnecting, about the movie, how much of a rekindling of her friendship had to happen on the movie set?
Well, we've known each other a long time. We're comfortable with each other, so I think those things help.
Through years and years of doing it anyway, and then knowing each other, there's a mutual trust there of some sort. The acting goes out of the scene, and rather you just sort of be with each other.
How do you like playing cops? It's a change. It's a switch. Yeah. You've played cops on and off. You've killed people, both of you. Let's admit it. Let's get it out.
I like to play people.
Which is good.
They are humans. I haven't gotten to the Martian thing yet, the alien thing. But we're working on it.
And you've been a thug, you've been a fucker.
What? Was that acceptable the way you just said it?
See,
you're just on the line.
Don't give me that face, because now I think I'm going to get killed.
Everybody.
And speaking of that face you just gave me, yeah. you you both have this weapon you can use as actors. Do you ever give that, like, dead-eye look to, like, a poor person who pulls you over or a waitress? Do you ever just throw it on somebody on the street just for fun?
Well, you sort of don't need to sometimes because it comes with the territory. I was driving, and I drove past this guy's parked car, and I knocked his rearview mirror off.
Totally
my fault, of course. So I stopped, naturally. He says, look at my mirror. What did you do? I said, well, whatever. I'll take care of it. You know, whatever. I rolled down my window. He came to the window, saw it was me, and he said, no, it's all right.
He
Don't
surrendered.
Worry.
Yeah. Do fans come up doing you guys? Do you get that a lot? Do you get people doing you because they want
you? You talking to me?
I get it. Last question. Where do you go to be your happiest? What do you associate when you close your eyes with being yourself and being happiest in life?
Be with my kids, going away and being with them. That's the happiest I can be.
I like just going away with my kids and going to, you know, like vacation in a country or something like that, just on a weekend or stuff, or reading a book. I like to read a lot. I read the newspapers. I watch the Today Show every day. Watching the Today Show since I was 10 years old.
So that's when you're happiest. Happiest, I think he just said, watching the Today Show.
Yes! Hi, Bob De Niro.
Bobby.
You know, I always said a smart man.
I knew I loved that guy.
Bob De Niro.
Right. Yeah. You know,
Pacino's
I thought Brian did a great job with that interview.
He did.
I
really
gotta
good
say,
job.
They were funny.
Nobody's seen Brian since the interview.
But as somebody said here while we're watching, they're charming together.
Yeah, they really are.
Very
it's
charming
great.
Together.
And the chemistry of the movie is terrific.
Actually, Al Pacino, I think, complimented Brian on his performance Saturday Night Live, and Brian blushed.
Oh.
Cute.
And now we're all in the happy family.
Yeah.
Man.
And the rest of it, you can see the whole thing on our website.
Right, todayshow.com.
Meanwhile, I noticed Pacino didn't jump in and say, yeah, I also watched the Today Show.
Well, you know, that's true.
We're getting them.
Hello?
What is that? I have no idea.
No.